Just in case you need a few ideas or a little inspiration of things that you could declutter during your spring cleaning, I have 35 for you today. Make sure that when you're decluttering, you donate what you can, and if something has to be disposed of, you do so responsibly. This list is by no means meaning that you have to get rid of something on this list. A lot of this is just meant for fun and also to give some people inspiration. So let's look at this with a light heart, everyone. If you're not familiar with my channel, I do these rapid fire, so we're gonna get started. Number one are duplicate photographs. You know, the pack of 20 school photos that you got back in the day when you were, I don't know, in 10th grade, and your mother planned on giving them to, I don't know who, 20, 30 people that you know, but now you have all of those copies and you're in your 30s. Number two are socks and underwear with holes in them. It's a very good possibility that if someone does end up seeing those, that you will feel embarrassed. I remember one time when I was probably in my early 20s, I got stopped in the mall and suckered into one of those kiosks things. They were selling those things you could put in a microwave to heat up that had all the like lavender and herbal stuff in it. Well, they wanted to put one on my foot. So they took my shoe off and look there, right at my big toe was a big ol' hole. Yeah, that was embarrassing. He laughed. I smiled. Number three are books that you will not read again, unless it's a reference book that you will need to go back and look at from time to time. Otherwise, if you know yourself well enough and you're not one of those people who can read a book a second time, share that knowledge, pass it on to somebody else. Trust me, there are some people that need to read some of those books these days. Number four, rusty anything in your kitchen because, ew. Number five, vitamins and supplements that didn't work. You know, that energy powder that didn't energize, that stool softener that didn't soften. Number six, photographs that make you go, ugh. Number seven, tarnished jewelry. If you can blow on the top of your jewelry box and a cloud of dust puffs out, then there's likely something in there that's tarnished. Number eight, childhood trophies. Now, keep the ones that are special to you, but nowadays they give out a lot of these participation trophies. No offense, that just seems wasteful. Number nine are school yearbooks. Do you really need one for every single year that you are in school? And when you do pass away, what is going to happen to those? Number 10, leggings that you can see through. I don't need to say anything else. Number 11 are Happy Meal toys. Happy Meal toys have gotten considerably cheaper and crappier as the years have gone on. Back in the 80s and 90s, Happy Meal toys were actually cool. I actually still have one of the little, do you remember it was like a train and it had Donald Duck in it and you wind it backwards and it goes like this? Yeah, we still have one of those and it still works. Now, you literally get stuff in the Happy Meal toys that is just utter crap. Number 12, random stuff stuck in your nightstand. If you're like me, I don't know what it is about nightstands, but the most random items that don't have a typical normal home in your home end up in a nightstand. Number 13 are slippers that you have worn so much that you can now see the padding where your heel is. Number 15, puzzles missing pieces. Wait, who does puzzles twice? Number 16, dead batteries. Are they rechargeable? No? Then are you, I don't know, using them for decoration? Number 17, wire hangers. No more wire hangers. Number 18, old bridesmaids' dresses. Are you really going to wear them again? Unless you plan on dressing it up as like a Halloween costume, you know, circa 1985. Number 19, bed pillows that are not comfortable. Bed pillows are for sleeping, and if it's not comfortable, you're probably not going to sleep very well. Number 20, receipts from furniture you bought 20 years ago. Now, show this to someone younger before you discard it so we can actually see how reasonable priced furniture was 20 years ago. Number 21 are containers that food was purchased in that's now empty, you've washed, and you've kept around for repurposing. But You have so many of them that you could fill up a recycling plant. Number 22 is expired sunscreen. That stuff does expire. And unless you want to be a lobster, you want to make sure it works. Number 23 are loofahs and body sponges. First of all, try to be more environmentally conscious about those, but if you really love them, try to replace them more often than not, because yuck. Number 24 are clothing items that your kids refuse to wear. This happened to me. I really wanted my daughter to wear overalls because I just think they are adorable on little ones. And I don't know what they're called in other countries. You guys can probably go ahead and tell me, but I think they are called something different. But I tried and she just refused to wear them. Number 25, anything with glitter. That stuff goes everywhere. Number 26, garbage. Because it's garbage? Number 27, single earrings. Oh, where did my little earring go? Oh, where could it have gone? Number 28, tights with runs. Who wears tights anymore? Number 29, half-finished craft projects. You know, that needlepoint that you started working on with the kitty cat and the cute little ball of yarn, but you only made it to one ear. Number 30, uncomfortable jeans. Seriously, jeans are supposed to be comfortable. Number 31, air mattresses which reach the ground by morning. Number 32, clothes that make you feel insecure. You know, too short, too low cut. Number 33, membership cards to places you're no longer a member of. Because you're no longer a member there? Number 34 are hats that do not flatter you. Number 35 are baskets or storage containers that are now empty after all of this decluttering. That is my list of 35 items that you can look to decluttering this spring. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I would love to have you back for more videos.